Hello children, welcome to my channel. In this video and coming videos we'll learn about the very first chapter of your 8th class science, which is crop production and management. In this video I'll teach you about how are different food crops produced and what are kharif crops and rabi crops. So in chapter 1 you will learn about the following things. First is agricultural practices, in which you will study about kharif and rabi crops. The second one is basic practices of crop production, which include preparation of soil, sowing, adding manure and fertilizers, irrigation, protection of crops from weeds, harvesting and storage, and then food from animals, that we'll cover afterwards. So you have learned that all the living organisms require food. Plants can make their food themselves by the process of photosynthesis. You have done this chapter in your previous class, how plants prepare their food. Animals including humans cannot make their own food, and we used to get our food from plants, and our food can be animal also. Human population is increasing at a rapid rate. In order to meet its food requirement, we not only need to enhance food production, but also need to manage production practices, that is storage and distribution of food also. So India's most important crops include cotton, tea, rice, wheat and sugarcane. Other important cash crops include jute, groundnuts, coffee, oil seeds and spices. So the practice of growing plants and rearing animals on a large scale for food, fiber and other useful products is called as agriculture. So we'll study about agricultural practices now. So first of all, we must know what is a crop. When plants of the same kind are cultivated at one place on a large scale, it is called a crop. For example, crop of wheat means that all the plants growing in a field are that of wheat. The products obtained from crops are referred to as a crop produce. So a crop grown for purpose of food is called as a food crop. For example, wheat and paddy. Whereas a crop grown for the purpose of sale as well as profit and for non-subsistence, that crop is called as the cash crop. For example, tea and coconut. So crops are of different types like cereals, vegetables and fruits. These can be classified on the basis of season in which they grow. India is a vast country and the climatic conditions like temperature, humidity and rainfall vary from one region to another. Accordingly, there is a rich variety of crops grown in different parts of country. So based on the season, the crops are of following types. The first one is a kharif crop. The crops which are sown in the rainy season, such crops are called as kharif crops. The rainy season in India is generally from June to September. These crops are grown in June and July and are harvested in September and October. They require more water for the growth and hence are grown during the monsoon season in India. Examples include paddy, maize, soybean, groundnut, cotton. Next one are rabi crops. These crops are grown between October and April. They require less water and hence are grown during the winter season. The examples include wheat, gram, pea, mustard, linseed, barley, etc. Do you know there is a third category of crops also? These crops are called as Z crops. These crops are grown on the irrigated lands which do not have to wait for monsoons. In the short duration between Rabi and Kharif season, these crops are grown. And mainly from March to June is the time period for their growth. Examples include watermelon, cucumber, muskmelon, sunflower, sugarcane. So students, the branch of agriculture that deals with science and art of production, improvement, marketing and use of fruits, vegetables, flowers and ornamental plants is called as horticulture. So this is all for this video. Subscribe to my channel and do not miss the next video in which I'll continue about the rest of the chapter. Stay connected. Bye.